So children, when we so we have this till now we have discussed about many separation techniques based upon the components present in that. Now we are going to discuss about the sublimation. Okay, sublimation is a kind of separation technique. This is used to separate the solids from the non-volatile solids. Okay, so what do you mean by volatile and non-volatile solids, children? So when we discuss camphor, when we discuss the camphor or naphthalene balls, you understand, no? What is naphthalene balls for good aroma in the wardrobes and even sinks? The yes, just a place, yes, to in order to avoid moths, in order to avoid the microorganisms, in order to avoid the fungus or any insects, so we place them. Okay, so when we place this, what happened? They'll gradually, the size of the naphthalene balls gradually decreases. Understood? The size of the naphthalene ball gradually decreases in the sense it can completely volatile. That means solid converting to gas. Okay, it won't melt, children. The sublimated solids, it won't melt. It just converts into gaseous state. Understood?
So ma'am, that if it is a salt solution, that if we like do like this and the salt will remain on the water, we will get like the vapors, right?
Ma'am, we cannot see screen also.
Yeah, I just uploaded the video, child. Wait. Just uploaded the video.
Ma'am, we can see.
You can see?
Yes, ma'am, you are showing the YouTube sublimation.
So ammonium chloride is taken in a china dish and a glass funnel is kept inverted on it.
Understood, children?
Clear my doubt about that. Is salt water and...
That is evaporation. Child Neha, that is evaporation, not sublimation. Evaporation means liquid converting to gas.
This is solid to vapor.
This is solid to vapor without undergoing liquid state. Without undergoing liquid state, the solid directly converting into gaseous state. That is sublimation. Evaporation means liquid to gas. Liquid to gas. Here sublimation is not done with all the salts. Only few salts will undergo sublimation. Only few salts will undergo sublimation. Understood? Here solid is converting to gas state. Okay, no more liquid is observed here. When we have seen evaporation, your doubt is with salt solution. When we take the salt solution and get evaporated, then you'll get only salt and water will be evaporated after drying. That is evaporation. That means liquid is converting to gas. Okay, here sublimation in the sense you will take the solid and will give the heat energy. When you have given the heat energy, it converts into gaseous state and adhere to the walls of the funnel. This is funnel. Funnel is used to separate the filtration process. So we'll take the funnel, inverted funnel, and we place it on the top of the china dish. Understood, children? Okay. So this inverted funnel is, this inverted funnel, and we plug here, this is nothing but a cotton plug. When we place the cotton plug, that means no heat energy, no vapors will be gone out from the funnel. Yes, going away from the funnel or gone out from the funnel. So what happened? This inverted funnel and the plug, we are tightly closing it so that the gas is adhering to the walls of the funnel. Okay, so after cooling, the gas again converted into solid. Understood? Solid is converting into gas and gas is converting into solid. That is nothing but sublimation.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, children, no need to answer. Please text it, then I can understand. Okay. I think there won't be any problem if you mute and unmute it. The session clearly. Okay. This is about the sublimation. So this sublimation is used to separate only sublimated salts, not all the salts. There are few salts which will undergo sublimation. Okay, you have seen the video also about the sublimation. What are the sublimated salts here? One is naphthalene balls. Another one is camphor. You know camphor? You know camphor, children? Camphor.
Yes, ma'am.
Kerpur. Kerpur only? Yes, in Hindi we call it as kerpur. Okay, the camphor is used. That is also a sublimizer one. When we leave the camphor in an open area, the camphor gradually reduces its size. There won't be any water molecules over there. The camphor gradually, day by day, it reduces its size. And that means what? Solid camphor is converted into gaseous state. There is no formation of liquid over here. Any doubts? Any doubts, Shilin?
Yeah,